Okay guys, I'm finally on my way home after running some errands this afternoon. I was just gonna maybe pick up one book at the library. I specifically had in mind Crimson Crown by Cinda Williams Chima because my library actually had that the last time I checked it out. I've checked it out previously and I did not get to it, but I really want to read it early next year so I can finish off the Seven Realms series. So I like went in specifically to see if they happen to have that book, because this branch that I go to is fairly small and a lot of times they don't have the books that I'm looking for and I have to like request it from a sister library or a sister branch. Anyways, I went and looked for that book, and then I was like, I'll just browse and see what else. I ended up with five books, and I didn't mean to. I'm really trying to read some of my own books next year that I haven't read, and I don't know if it's going to happen. Anyways, I want to give you a reading update. So today is December 20th. The last time we talked, I mentioned I was considering DNFing a book that I was 57% through, and that book was The Girl in Times Square by Paullina Simons. I had requested this book off of NetGalley or Edelweiss as an ARC. What I didn't realize is that this book is already out, but the paperback version of it is coming out next month. I didn't know that publishers did ARCs for books that are being released in paperback, so that was a little weird, but I didn't realize that until after I was approved for the book. Anyways, I think I've already mentioned the reasons why I thought I might like this book. It turns out I really don't like this book, and I have officially decided to DNF it. I had originally planned on kind of talking about some of my reasons for wanting to DNF it, but I think I have a lot more thoughts about it than I originally thought I did, and I think I might make a separate like review rant video about it. I mean, I have enough thoughts that I would probably talk for about 5 minutes, and this video is already long enough. I don't really need to add an additional 5 minutes to this video. Keep an eye out for that review to come at some point. Yeah, I kind of have a lot of things to say about why I didn't finish it. I mean, it kind of takes a lot for me to get 60% through a book and decide that I don't want to read it. So after that, I picked up an old ARC that I have had on my Kindle for a while that I was approved for earlier this year. It was a book that came out in the summer or in the spring, I think. I'm not sure. It's called Towards a Secret Sky by Heather, I think it starts with an M. I'll put all the info on the screen. I'm trying to go through some of my backlog of ARCs from like NetGalley and Edelweiss and read them and review them so I can kind of get them off my plate. Anyways, this one, I don't even remember why I requested it because I requested it so long ago, but I guess I thought it sounded interesting. It's about this girl whose parents are dead, like at the beginning. It starts with the funeral of her mom, and then she ends up having to go live with her grandparents in Ireland. I only read 11% before I decided that I did not want to read this book. Oh, that lighting is a little bit better. But already in that 11%, I mean, most of it was her complaining about her grandparents, and I don't know if maybe there's something weird going on with her grandparents, like they're not really her grandparents, or there's some sort of family secret, or there's something weird going on there. I mean, within the first 11%, most of what she did was complain about having to live in Ireland and complained about the food and how it was like gross. I mean, that was just kind of boring to read about. Like, I don't really care that the food is gross or that you think the food is gross. And then the first two like male characters she comes across, immediately she's like, oh my god, this guy is so hot and hope he likes me. It was very much like objectifying the guys and talking about how attractive they were and how they made her heart flutter. I don't know, I just immediately could tell that that was not the book for me. Not interested in that level of romance. I need a little more story, a little more plot. I know some people will say I didn't give the book a fair shot, but I just already within the first 11% had so many things that were aggravating me. And I know that I should DNF a book when I go to pick it up and it feels like a chore to read. I think I read that book 3 nights in a row before I went to bed. Yeah, it's just definitely not my type of book. So that one gets a 1 star for me. I guess I didn't say, but I also would give The Girl in Times Square probably 2 stars because it is fairly readable. I just had problems with it. And then last night, after I decided that I was definitely DNFing Towards a Secret Sky, I picked up another ARC on my Kindle. Like I said, I'm trying to get through them. This one is actually for a book that is not released yet. It's coming out at the end of January. It is The Keeper, or maybe it's just Keeper, by Kim Chance, who is an author tuber. That's how I first heard about her book. I found her author tube channel when I was in my NaNoWriMo phase. And I've been watching her videos ever since. She's really sweet. I love her videos. I think she makes great content. I watch a lot of author tubers that I've realized I haven't read anything that they've written. And so when I saw her arc on NetGalley or Edelweiss, I, of course, jumped at the chance to get it. And I was really, really excited when they approved me for it. And I've kind of been holding off reading it because I wanted to read it a little bit closer to the release date. But last night, just in such a, like, kind of bummed out mood after DNFing two books in a row, basically. So I was like, you know what? I'm excited to read Keeper. I'm just gonna pick it up and I'm gonna read it. And I read 11% in one night compared to Towards a Secret Sky that it took me three nights to read 11%. I can definitely say that I'm enjoying it. It's a lot better than the other two, like, ebooks that I had been trying to read lately. The story started out with a bang and I'm interested to see where it goes. All right, I will keep you guys updated on my reading for the rest of the month. Hello, bookworms. It's Jade from Bedtime Bookworm. Why am I doing my intro? So it is currently Friday morning. God, I never look at the date before I start these things. So I finished a book last night. I had been reading / listening to Salt to the Sea by Ruta. This book, I think, might be fairly short because I finished it really quickly. Last night, I realized that Salt to the Sea was going to expire today. And I was like, oh my god, I need to listen to this whole thing right now. I was about 45% through the book. I sat down and did some cross-stitching and was listening to it. And got like another hour done, but I still had like 3 hours left. And I really needed to hurry it up if I wanted to finish the book last night. So I ended up reading along with the audiobook, which when I do that, I can usually listen to it faster than if I'm not reading along. But I listened to it on 2x speed and like read along with it, and it was so good, guys. Oh, my heart. Okay, so Salt of the Sea is set during like World War II, and it's about like a group of people that were trying to escape from Russia, or like Prussia, or part of, really not great with history, guys. But they were trying to escape into Germany. The story is told from 4 point of views. And I will say that at first the audiobook was really confusing because their chapters are all really short and they like alternate, but not always in the same order either. The first 40 minutes I was listening to the audiobook, I was kind of confused. And then that night I went back and read through the ebook to kind of set these characters in my mind. And once I had a better idea of who was who out of the 4 different point of views, I was able to listen to the audiobook just fine and keep up with what was going on. 3 of them are some of these refugees, and one of them is actually a German soldier. He was so interesting. He's definitely like a really creepy character. That was a point of view that I was like not really expecting to see from the book, but it was really interesting, and I'm really glad Ruta Sepetys included that. You see these 4 point of views and how they kind of weave together. And okay, I'm so bad at explaining books. Why am I on book 2? Like I said, these people are trying to escape into Germany, and so they all get on this boat. I mean, you know before going into the book that this boat is kind of like a Titanic scenario where something really bad happened and a bunch of people died. And I was actually confused because I thought more of the book would take place on the boat, but now that I'm done reading it, I'm actually really glad that more of the book didn't take place on the boat. I mean, there was only so much you can really do on a boat anyways. I thought the pacing was beautiful. It worked so well. The writing was great. I love all of these characters. It's so interesting because all the chapters are really short and you only get like a glimpse into each of these characters' minds, but somehow you're able to get really well-developed characters even from these little glimpses and just how they all tie together and then how everything ends. And it was just beautiful and I loved it. I gave it a 5 out of 5 stars. It was so good. It was so hard to read because while you're reading it, you know that this boat that they're going towards and get on is going to sink, and you know that things just aren't going to turn out well. And oh, and the romance, there's a ship that I ship so hard in this book. So good. But I mean, watching them like flirt with each other and, you know, start developing feelings was so hard. Can't recommend it enough if you like historical fiction, and especially if you like books set during the World War II time period and you want to hear about something that happened that I've never heard about before until I read this book or heard about this book. Apparently this boat that sank, it's the biggest maritime disaster in history. So bigger than the Titanic, bigger than, they named a couple other boats that I had also never heard of. It was like a really big thing that happened and like nobody heard about it because it kind of got swept under the rug. So Ruta Sepetys at the end of her books does a really interesting author note where she talks about how she wrote the story and like all the people that she interviewed. Hopefully I'm not misremembering, but I think one of her family members was actually supposed to be on this boat, but they ended up traveling a different way. Like they ended up not going on the boat. And so they are the ones who talked to her, Ruta Sepetys, and was like, you should write a story about this because nobody has really heard about it. You might have noticed that I haven't done any of those like end of year 2017 videos yet. I'm one of those people who like refuses to do those videos until 2017 is over, and this is why. Today is December 22nd, and last night I just finished an amazing book that is potentially one of my top books of the year. I'm gonna have a really hard time putting together the top books of the year list because I've read so many amazing books this year. Okay, bye!
Hey guys, so it is officially January 2nd, so it's time to wrap up this reading vlog. I apologize if I sound a little funny or I'm not as perky as I usually am, although I don't personally think I'm all that perky and produced anyways, but I do have a little bit of a cold that I'm getting over, but I'm starting to feel better. Since the last clip that I filmed, I guess maybe like last 10 days or so of December, I didn't finish any books. I also didn't do a whole lot of reading because that's right around the holidays, and I was fairly busy for Christmas and a few days after that. But in addition to the holidays taking away my reading time, I also bought a new video game, which I don't video game a lot, but occasionally there'll be a game on sale and I'll get it and I get kind of sucked in and obsessed with it for a little while. Currently, I am very obsessed with Final Fantasy X. I've never played it before. I've only played one Final Fantasy before. It was 13 and it was a long time ago, but I saw Final Fantasy X and X-2 Remastered was on sale and I jumped at the opportunity to grab it because I've heard such good things about it and totally got sucked in. I've been playing a lot of video games and not reading all that much. Since my last clip, I haven't finished any books and I am still reading The Final Empire by Brandon Sanderson, also still reading Keeper by Kim Chance. So just a quick recap before I let you guys go. I read and finished 4 books in the month of December. Those were The Queen of the Tierling and The Invasion of the Tierling by Erica Johansson. I gave those both 5 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed them. I listened to them both on audiobook. And then I also finished Isle of Blood by Rick Yancey, which is the 3rd book in the Monstromologist series. It was a solid 4 out of 5 stars. I really enjoyed that, and I look forward to reading the final installment of that series next October. And then I also finished Salt to the Sea by Ruta, which I also gave 5 out of 5 stars, and I absolutely loved it. She's definitely one of my new favorite authors, and I look forward to reading more of her stuff in the future. In addition to finishing those 4 books, I DNF'd 2. The first book that I DNF'd in the month of December was The Girl in Times Square by Paullina Simons. I know you guys saw a little bit of my struggle with that book during this month. I'm planning to do a standalone book review slash rant for that book, although it might not be up for a little while, but just know that I gave it 2 out of 5 stars and I read about 60% before I decided to give up on that one. And then I also DNF'd Towards a Secret Sky by Heather Maclean. I only read 11% of that book, but I knew right from the beginning that I was not going to enjoy it. It was not for me, and I DNF'd it because life is too short to read books that you're not gonna like. Okay, I think that wraps up my December. Like I said in the intro to the first reading vlog, I will continue to do this sort of reading vlog for January. Hopefully I can keep my thoughts a little more concise and make it just one video instead of splitting out into 2. I really think I just need to practice at doing this type of reading updates. If you like this type of reading vlog, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you like bookish content. I post a video at least once a week. I think that's all I have for now, so thank you so much for watching, and until next time, bookworms, keep reading. Bye.